Hey, Danny Smith, MMK. I'm sitting here at the birthplace on the porch of the birth house. And I just want to say, hey, appreciate you and thank you for watching The Matt Dollar Show.
Today here on the Matt Dollar Show, I'm in Tupelo, Mississippi, visiting with a good friend of mine by the name of Danny Smith. Danny,
Matt,
tell all of our viewers out here on MeTV a little bit about yourself, who you are.
My name's Danny Smith, and I'll tell you, my grandfather, Travis Smith, and Elvis's mother were brother and sister.
Okay.
My dad was Elvis's first cousin. And him and my grandparents and my dad's older brother, they actually moved from Tupelo with Elvis and Gladys and Vernon to Memphis to pursue a better life, a better job.
And that was really a family thing at the time, wasn't it?
Yes, sir.
Everybody really just, dying for a better life.
Poor and needed to find, like I said, better work, and Memphis was the place, from what I understood during that time.
And that wasn't an uncommon thing at the time. It's like even my family, my viewers know I'm from a place in Tennessee called Dollar Holler.
Dollar Holler.
Okay.
Yeah.
And it sounds like a joke, you know, but it was just that my grandparents and them were really poor, really struggling, sharecroppers and everything, you know, just trying to do the best they could to survive.
Same way back then. That's, you know, I mean, I guess it was all over.
Oh yeah, there's a lot of
people struggling and doing the best they could do, you know, try to
tell survive. Me a little bit about your mom and dad. I know she met Elvis, I guess your dad too. I'd heard that he had took her to Graceland one night, I guess, maybe to meet or something. Is that how that happened?
Well, he did. They actually went to the same high school and they dated, and yes, of course, you know, he through dating and stuff, took her to Graceland and met Elvis, and basically from that point, it was just, like I said, it was already that relationship, you know, with Dad and Elvis, and then, you know, and then Mom, and just pretty much our whole life. I mean, Dad, he did different things at different times, Matt, but...
Was that Humes High that they went to school?
No, it was actually Whitehaven.
Whitehaven.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. That's where they went to school. But like I said,
your mom and dad's been together forever, right?
Yeah. I mean, you put me on the spot when you say I don't know exactly how many years, but yes, they
for a long time.
For a long time, and been through a lot. There definitely is a love there that's
an unconditional
love. It's got to be.
Yeah, you can tell. I mean, I've seen lots of pictures and stuff.
Yes.
It's awesome. But so tell me, what all did your dad do for Elvis? Like, what was one of his first jobs, you think?
Well, a little bit, like I said, he's one of the guys. I mean, he, you know, did whatever was asked of him to do. I mean, as far as, taking care of, you know, wardrobe, you know, going on tour, just, you know, pretty much whatever it took. Now, pretty much, I would say...
with him right up till the end, right?
Right. And I would say pretty much toward the middle of probably this career, and especially toward the end. I mean, Mom and Dad was basically just with him a lot of times 24/7, and really, I mean, you say work, but it was just him having
his family,
right? Him having Dad there, and they just, but like I said, you know, he did go on tour and whatever was, you know, that was needed to be done. I mean, Dad was like,
you could always count on Billy, huh?
Well, you could always count on a lot of the guys. I mean, yeah. they were great. That was a bond of a family that just is so different today. You know, you don't see it.
It's gone now. People just don't. Family values are not what they once were. You know?
Exactly. That, and like I said, but that group of guys was just, we were like, I mean, it was like one big family. I mean, and their kids, just like us, you know, we grew up and played together and lived together just as they did.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sure. So what would you be your best memory, you think, of being there with your dad at Graceland? Because y'all lived there on the property, right?
Yes, we did. We lived at Grayson the last few years of his life. I think we moved up there 74, 75, somewhere around there, and we was there until he passed away, and we moved shortly after. To pinpoint one, Matt, it's just, I mean, that was a life that I thank God for. It was wonderful. I mean, there's so many. Like I said, I've told, you know, in some of my videos that, you know, some of the stories of riding the golf carts, snowmobiles, going to the movies, renting out Liberty Land, just swimming, running around Graceland, playing in the racquetball court. Of course, he had a pinball machine
down
there. Just, yeah. I mean, not to ignore your question, just there were so many. I mean, I could sit, like I said, name, but you know, there was a lot. With Dad, you know, we're still a close knit family, and always will be. I mean, we've never been far from one another, and never will.
How old is your dad now?
My dad is 76.
76, yep. And he is very sharp still. Let me tell you what, people, there is a lot of information. If you want to know any information about Elvis as a person, as a family member, the truth about a lot of things that you may wonder about, you need to check out their channel. It's his channel, right? It's Memphis Mafia.
Well, it's our family, but yes, I actually got it started. It's called Memphis Mafia Kid. It's on YouTube, and what we do is try to tell some of our stories. We answer questions, tell about our life with Elvis. I also have special guests on, some of the other guys that work for Elvis. Just people, different people like that, plan on getting more. Hopefully, you know, we're doing this.
And
we're going to have you on my channel, like I said, and
good,
you
deal.
Know, talk about different things with you. So.
Yeah, and we're hoping to do, you know, all my viewers there in the Tennessee area, you know, y'all know what I do as far as fundraising events and concerts and displays and stuff like that. And we're going to try to team up and do some things together because, you know, it's just amazing. The Elvis family out here is just, it's awesome. I mean, and many people from around the world, and they act like they've known you forever.
Forever.
And it's all because of Elvis.
42 years later. Like me and you, Matt, was talking earlier, you know, we've been to the birthplace, and you see, you know, what amazes me is the young folks.
Oh, yeah, little kids.
And it's like, you know, where and how, because, you know, I was a kid and a teenager, you know, when Elvis passed away,
mm-hmm.
and you was a young man, and they're younger, you know, they're our age.
I know
when
now.
We was that age, you know,
yeah.
And it just
blows my mind.
But I don't know, charisma, what the word would be. Elvis just had that effect. Not only was he, you know, entertainer and a singer, but even just that's what it's hard. A lot of people ask is, of just of being family and being there. He was, but you still knew. Yeah. I mean, it was like Elvis Presley, and you know. And I've said in my video, you wanted to look at him. You couldn't not keep
couldn't take your
to
eyes
stare
off.
At
yeah,
him.
It's like, you know, I tell my viewers, I've told people at my shows, and maybe you can help me with this. You know, to where they don't think I'm just out there. But it's like the day I met Elvis. Seeing Elvis in person, it was amazing.
And
you could feel it when he walked in.
You could. And I've said that, and other people have said it, and it was the truth. If we was in Graceland, or anywhere, but just say sitting in Graceland, I'm sitting in the kitchen at times, and he would walk downstairs and totally have my back, never see him or whatever, and you just... You got the chills, the hair stood up on the back of your neck, and you knew
what do you
that
think,
he was in the room.
What do you think? Why do you think it was that way with him?
To be honest, like I said, Elvis had more to me than just the looks, of course, the voice, the singing. He just had, I want to say and think, just that God-given gift all over,
everywhere,
that just made people just, you know, want to look at him, want to see him, want to talk, and his heart was huge.
Yeah, it's amazing because me and my wife, we always say, man, God was feeling good the day he made Elvis. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
because
I totally agree with that.
It's amazing. It changed my life forever.
Well, it changed mine, and look, like we're talking about, I think it changed. We won't say everybody's, but a good portion of this world, it changed.
Oh,
I mean,
yeah.
There's people from all over the world, and for a man that never really did a worldwide tour, never played,
never had to leave the country,
and he's known by one name, Elvis.
Yeah, but I mean, say, tell me this. You got to see Elvis in concert, right? Wasn't that at Mid-South Coliseum?
Yes, that was at the Mid-South Coliseum. And just like everybody else, that was one. I mean, I was awed, couldn't wait to see him. And then when he got on stage and performed, it was just like, you know, even though, like I said, he was Elvis, the cousin, the family that we hung out and did crazy, but he was Elvis Presley. That makes sense.
Yeah.
It's hard to make sense. I mean,
you had saw other artists before him, right? You had saw some
sure. I mean,
70s rock bands,
yeah,
and stuff in concert.
Right. In my day, you know, we went. Me and you talked about earlier, Kiss.
Yeah, I went to see Kiss.
You know, and then growing up in the later years, I mean, I love music, but I will always
and you know what a big show Kiss did.
Sure.
Now it was impressive. But I tell you what, Elvis just walking out of the hotel,
exactly,
took the cape.
Exactly. Well, and, you know, you have like Garth, you know, and people, everybody has their own, but it's just like you said, to me, the most exciting thing in the world was when it would go off and those drums would go to rolling, and you knew in any minute he was fixing to walk out on that stage.
And I bet you were proud.
And bam, when he did, it was
amazing.
Just like for everybody, like
yeah.
I said. I
can only imagine how proud you were.
Sure. And during that concert, you talk about, you mentioned, it was a great concert. And then afterwards, and I may have told it in one of the videos, I didn't, but during that time, I had just got a drum set and was learning, trying to play drums, which I did for a few years, but never got. But anyway, we went backstage and we were talking, and Ronnie Tutt had been out about it, and he called me over, and he actually gave me the drumsticks.
Oh, really?
From that concert, and I still have them today.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
That's something you should show, or have you showed on your channel?
I haven't showed them, but I'm going to, yeah.
Well, yeah, that's awesome. What a souvenir. But, so what are you thinking about maybe some future plans that maybe me and you could do together?
Well, it's like we talked about. I you know, I'd love, and I've been talking with other folks, but maybe putting together a festival, if you may, or an Elvis maybe weekend or something, like, you know,
maybe something
you're talking
everybody
about.
Would be welcome to.
You know, having you know, you do the show, and then maybe, you know, Mom and Dad and me and Joey, and we could do some meet and greet. That
yeah,
would be
maybe
fantastic.
We could have Dakota come down.
Dakota,
and meet
yeah,
and greet everybody,
and you know, do a question and answer, and spend that's during the Elvis festivals in June here in Tupelo, and during Elvis Week, as you know, it's hard. We don't get a chance to spend as much time as we'd love to.
I'm sure.
With and I said, people call them Elvis fans. Everybody knows out there what I say on my channel. Y'all are my Elvis family. And always will be. So, you know, anytime we could put something together, maybe, and get everybody together just to talk.
Oh yeah.
Ask questions. I mean, it's great to see a lot of these people I've known my whole life, and then I meet new folks every single day, and that's what's so wonderful about this.
Oh yeah,
thing.
And I appreciate you
meeting us like you have
because we came down, you know, yesterday. 100 miles down there, 100 miles back, 100 miles today, and we're going to go back. And you know what? I'd do it 10 times this week if I had to.
Well, and I would meet with you just like, you know.
I appreciate it.
Like when you called, you know, with Joey. Hey, you know, and I tell not just you, but anybody. If you know, I'm like everybody else. I, you know, I try to work and make a living. But if you let me know, hey, if you're going to be around the Tupelo area or even Memphis area when I'm up that way, I'm more than happy. My brother, mom and dad, when they're able, we're more than happy to meet and talk to any of you. I mean, y'all are why Elvis is who he is.
And you know, who's some of the other people that they can go on YouTube and watch? The Spa Guy?
Yeah. The Spa Guy does an excellent channel. He's a good friend of mine.
A lot of great information on there.
That's what I was going to say, as far as I guess what you call a historian or...
Yeah.
Or what, I mean, he...
He's like an Elvis biographer, and he
tracks down stuff, and he's a lot like we are. He's different, but we do videos as actual stories, but Spa Guy actually finds...
the places it happened.
Exactly.
And
tries to give you all the knowledge that maybe if a building even wasn't there, he might show you where it was, and then you'll have a story about it. Like I said, he's a great fella. If you get a chance, please watch him and subscribe to his channel. I think you'll enjoy it and find out a lot about it.
Oh, for sure. And then we have people like John Daly.
John does an excellent job.
Great guy. I've talked to him a few times. He's got lots of memorabilia. And what is the festival he puts on?
He puts it on during Elvis Week. Also, he has done it, and I'm sure he'll do it during the birthday. It maybe not quite as many days or as big as the Elvis Week, but he does a fantastic job. John tries to put it together. He tries to get as many of the Elvis connections, family, friends, anything
vendors,
to do with Elvis, right, vendors, and tries to put it all together the best he can. And the thing about John is he does not charge one penny.
Yeah. Well, he invited me to come to the last one. I just couldn't get down there to it, and I regretted not being able to go.
Well, hopefully in the future
you can.
I'm coming
this year for sure. So what do you think about Elvis Week this coming year? What kind of plans have you got?
I actually hadn't really started. We're just starting to make plans. I'm sure that as long as John is doing his festival, that's the main place that I know that I will be.
Okay.
For the simple fact, like I said, John puts on a good show. John's a good friend, and we just have a good time. And then everybody, you know, seems to be around there. Now, other little things we may do, and I like to throw, I don't know if you call them pitches, but like my girl Missy at Marlowe's.
Oh, yeah.
Restaurant.
Great place.
If you're ever down Memphis Way and you eat at a place, try Marlowe's. Yeah, not only is the service great, but the food is fantastic.
And it's full of interesting artifacts and stuff.
Yeah,
it's
souvenir
really
shop, everything. So.
And I think John's got something to do with souvenirs in there.
Yeah, he does. And they have, if you're at a hotel or something, maybe not have transportation, they have pink limousines.
Yeah,
that
they
will
go around
actually
town and pick up
right,
the
will pick you up and take you to the restaurant to eat and take you back. So, I mean, you can't ask for any more than that.
So if you're looking for John, you'll look at some Elvis memorabilia, or you don't talk to him about the festival or Elvis Week or anything, look up the Elvis Pawn Shop. I think it's how it's listed on Facebook, right?
It is, Elvis Pawn Shop. And like I said, if he doesn't have it, he can probably get it.
For sure.
He's got it that way.
And he's also got an eBay store, too, I think, where he sells
it. I think he does, yes. But, you know, it's just, like I said, you know, with all of what he puts together and everybody, we've just enjoyed doing it over the years. And right now, like I said, hadn't locked any plans in, but I'm sure, and we'll put out there on my channel, he will, Spy Guy.
Sure. And like I said, you know, all my viewers is there in Tennessee, Virginia, Kentucky on ARC TV, Me TV, my YouTube channel. I've got about 1 million of you guys a week, and I'm so thankful for you guys, and you're the reason why I do this, not just the Elvis fans, everyone who watches. And it's great people like this right here that makes my show possible.
I appreciate that. Yeah, we, like I said, I enjoy it, man. I enjoy it.
And what kind of merchandise do you guys usually have?
I have, we're just starting to get into it. I have some t-shirts, different kinds. We have a slogan. I say a slogan. We have a saying at the end of our video that I actually started, and it comes from the heart. We always end our videos with a saying called, "We always live Elvis." And I have that, some shirts like that. I also have, like I said, my channel is the Memphis Mafia Kid. I have MMK shirts, Memphis Mafia Kid shirts, some bracelets.
Yeah.
We have photos. You know, just a few little things like that. But if you're interested in something like that, hey, just go on my YouTube channel, and where it says comments, ask me about the merchandise, and I can tell you how to get some of it. Yeah, pretty easy.
Yeah, and you're going to start blowing them up with some better stuff, because I'm going to help you out with some of that stuff.
We sure are. Like I said, this thing just going, it's only been less than 2 years, but we're going to take the whole thing to the next dimension.
Does it cost anything to subscribe?
You know? No, sir. A lot of people think that it's absolutely free. If you subscribe, like Spy Guy has said in these videos, and I've said, and Matt knows,
yeah,
it's just like viewers. That's how we get our ratings, and you know, you have to stay at a certain level if you actually want to be out there for the folks.
Oh, so, yeah,
and
sure.
You know a lot about that. So.
Yes, sir. But I'd like to thank everybody on the Matt Dollar Show today, and thank Joey Smith here.
Watch out. He picks at me, my brother's Joey.
Gotta fix that. That's his brother. This is Danny Smith. Joey's his brother.
Right.
And they are brothers for sure, 110%. And Joey paid me to say that.
Brothers forever. But no, hey, Matt, I do want to say, man, look, I appreciate you having me on your show. And
it's an honor.
And thank y'all for having me on the Matt Dollar Show.
And what would you like to say before you leave?
Hey, what do we say, Matt?
We always live Elvis.